you want to keep up to date with the developments in the data analytics industry, you came to the right place. I'll tell you all you need to know about and prepare you to stay up to date in this fast-changing industry. In this video, I'll talk about the future of data analytics and show you where the industry is headed. Super useful, definitely a must-watch for any data analyst. Let's go. Hey, my name's Tom. I've been in the world of data for more than 5 years, and I've seen the industry undergo a lot of drastic changes in that time. To stay competitive as an expert in the field, you always need to stay up to date with the latest trends in the field and implement them in your work. To help you stay informed, we at Career Foundry have made a list of the latest data analytic trends going into 2023, and we'll discuss which way the industry is headed in the near future. As a side note, some of these trends are already happening, some of them will happen gradually, and some of them will depend on the developments of future technology. But you need to know about them if you want to be an important asset for any business. There's a lot to go through in this video, so let's get started. Data democratization means giving access to data to all members of staff, whether they be technical employees or not. It's agreed these days that data-driven decisions make for better decisions. What is a data-driven decision? It means relying on data rather than relying on your intuition. So, more and more companies are providing in-house training to educate their staff on data literacy. What is data literacy? It just means that all your members of staff should be familiar with the techniques and principles of working with data. If you want to improve your data literacy skills, why don't you check out Career Foundry's free online short course on data analytics? The link for it is in the description below. Once you've completed it, you'll be in a position to speak in a data literate manner, and you'll be able to facilitate data democratization in your circle. However, just because data is being democratized doesn't mean we don't need technical expertise. Technical experts are still required to oversee data analytics pipelines, for example, and to help mentor and provide support to non-technical members of staff. We can see examples of the rise in data democratization by the rise in popularity of dashboarding tools like Looker, Tableau, and Power BI. But it's not just analytics departments that are taking advantage of data. Departments like marketing, growth, and product also have a need for data democratization. And this can be seen in the rise of tools supporting these areas, like AB Tasty for AB tests, User Flow or User Pilot for guided onboarding, and Mixed Panel or Heap for product analytics. And there's one other area in which data democratization can be seen, and that's with the rise of the API network. Increasingly, companies are making their data publicly available through the provision of APIs. A great example of a website that's taking advantage of this is Rapid API. Feel free to check it out to see just how many companies provide lots and lots of great content for you to consume. Next up, we have artificial intelligence. Data analytics is evolving alongside the growth in AI, and this allows data analysts and other workers to be more productive when doing data analytics. The market is now flooded with loads of great new AI products which are easily integratable into your data analytics pipelines. The best AI out there helps support human creativity and productivity rather than replacing it. If you want a code-related example, why don't you look at OpenAI's Copilot, which is now integrated into GitHub and allows coders to write code more productively and faster than ever before. So, in 2023 and beyond, data analysts will increasingly rely on machine learning solutions to help them do their jobs more productively. Let's take a look at some examples which are already here. Smart tooling. This means AI tools which automatically convert data in unstructured formats, for example, pieces of paper, websites, or Excel spreadsheets, and turns them into SQL structured database systems. This takes away a lot of the heavy lifting that data analysts tend to do at the beginning of a project. Natural language processing. Data analysts are now able to query databases using natural language instead of traditional code bases like SQL or Python. Analysts are also able to use natural language processing to interactively monitor a particular company's presence on social media and to be aware of things like brand awareness, brand sentiment analysis, etc. Analysts are also able to embed information about a company, for example, articles of incorporation or investor reports, into structured data formats like knowledge graphs, which can then later be queried in a more effective way. Time series analysis. This means building machine learning models to automatically detect risk triggers in a company's financial data or other user-related data and take action or provide more analytics on the basis of those triggers. Lots of people, when they hear about AI, worry that machines are going to take away their jobs. But I'm here as a data scientist to tell you that's not the case. Now let's take a look at embedded analytics. You've probably heard a lot in the news recently about virtual reality VR and augmented reality AR. Whether it's recent challenges at Meta, the release of Apple glasses in the next couple of years, the new Oculus Quest Pro, or cast your mind back to the challenges that Google had releasing Google Glass. Well, some of the hype is real. Advancements in hardware, in AR and VR, are also allowing analysts to provide new ways for users to visualize and understand data. Embedded data will be available via AR hardware for users to see more information than ever before about any product and service that they're consuming. Imagine you're in a supermarket and you can look at a product and with a simple click of a button, discover its carbon footprint, its calorific content, its precise sourcing information, as well as any recipes that you might be able to use it in. This embedding of analytical information facilitates data democratization in the future. Now let's think about VR. During the recent COVID pandemic, we all saw the need for remote working. But one of the big drawbacks of working remotely is the loss of human connectivity via online meetings like Zoom and Google Meet. So how can VR help us with that? In fully immersive virtual boardrooms with good avatars with realistic emotional expressions, it might be possible to recreate the sense of connection that humans feel when they're physically located in a space close to each other. It allows for the interpretation of eye contact and other non-verbal cues that people lose through these online meetings. Furthermore, in a fully virtual space, the ability for analysts to use data geometrically and interactively and three-dimensionally rather than via PowerPoint presentations or other more old-fashioned techniques will allow consumers of data to more easily understand the messages that the analysts are trying to convey. In a fully virtual world, data analysts will be free to use way more creative techniques in order to explain their data. So of all the techniques that a data analyst needs to have, for example, cleaning, acquisition, and preparation, data visualization will probably be most enhanced by VR adoption. If you're enjoying this video and you want to see more great content about data analytics, UX, or others, feel free to like and subscribe to the Career Foundry YouTube channel. The future of data analytics will not be the same as the present. Currently, if you want an effective data analytics solution, you'll normally need to hire a few data engineers to create your data pipelines and a few data analysts to analyze the data within and create effective data visualizations to share with the wider business. This can be a restrictive expense for many businesses starting out. It's also not easy to hire the tech talent you need. And this is where DaaS comes to help. Data as a service, or DaaS for short, refers to cloud-based software tools which allow users to manage their analytics requirements, such as data warehouses or business intelligence tools. These DaaS tools can be run from anywhere and hosted anywhere. They can be small or large. In essence, it allows subscribers to provide data analytics services without the need for a data engineering or data analytics department on hand. DaaS should ultimately lead to an increase in productivity for small and mid-sized firms because you don't need to hire as many data engineers, software engineers, and data analysts as before. The use of DaaS in big data analytics will allow analysts to share data more easily than before and will simplify business tasks and processes. As more businesses integrate their products and services into the cloud, so DaaS has become a more common method for integrating, managing, and delivering data analytics services. Furthermore, in recent times, we've seen the growth in a new type of product, the so-called low-code or no-code analytics platforms. These are platforms for users who have no coding background, usually involving drag and drop interfaces. It allows users to create analytics pipelines and visualization dashboards without any technical background. This has further removed barriers to entry for small to mid-sized firms looking for data-driven decisions, but without the budget to hire a large suite of in-house analysts or engineers. Some examples of low or no-code analytics platforms include Good Data, Bold BI, and Price Loop. Now let's take a look at data governance. As we all know, more and more data is both being produced and consumed in the modern economy. Along with the rise in data governance comes the rise in concerns of individuals about how their data is being produced and consumed. To handle these concerns, we've seen the rise in data governance. So, what is data governance? Data governance means ensuring that the data that you create is of high quality and ensuring that that data meets all the requirements of the necessary regulations of the area in which the data is both produced and consumed. Basically, let's make good quality data and let's not break any laws. So, all firms these days should take care to create a good data governance strategy. A good strategy ensures data protection and tries to ensure that data is of the highest quality possible. Not having a strategy can result in poor quality data, missing out on business opportunities, and in the worst case, incurring regulatory fines or even jail time. Many of our European followers will know about the GDPR rules, but similar rules exist in other parts of the world as well. Regarding GDPR, you may have heard in recent news about big tech companies facing fines and other penalties in the European Union because of their inability to meet GDPR requirements. So it's super important for all companies to have good data governance structures in place. In addition to data governance strategies, small to mid-sized firms will often be required to hire data protection officers to ensure that the data is in adherence with the data governance strategy. But companies aren't the only ones who face data governance problems. Consumers also have their burden of responsibility to bear. Quick question to you. When was the last time you actually read the terms and the conditions of a contract on an app that you use or update? I know it's hard for me to do that. And that's why legal tech firms all across the globe are springing up to help us meet our data governance challenges as private consumers of data. Consequently, I perceive a niche in the future for disruptive legal tech firms helping consumers to understand their contractual requirements using artificial intelligence and other machine learning. But there are players already in the space. Why don't you take a look at Contract Book? Next up, we have the rise of IoT and real-time data. By now, most of you will have heard of the rise of the Internet of Things, also known as IoT. Whether it's your robot Hoover, your smart speaker in the corner, hardware is increasingly used to track and analyze human behavior. The rise of IoT means that more products and services are generating real-time data. Real-time data is typically unstructured and high in volume. That means you get a lot of it and it's very, very messy. But if you know how to work with unstructured real-time data, you can find invaluable insights into the world that will allow you to add real business value. Current examples include Ring, which is a smart device with an associated app, which allow users to monitor video and sound data around the house. Google Maps also uses IoT to monitor real-time traffic information and provide real-time updates on congested traffic in an area near you. So why is this relevant for data analysts? Well, the more real-time data we can capture about the users of any given system, the better we can understand them. And consequently, data analysts will be able to unlock new areas of value for the business that they work in. And with the rise of IoT and real-time data come associated concerns with data privacy. So I predict this will see an associated rise with more effective data anonymization tactics. This could include more effective hashing algorithms to ensure that all user-sensitive data is anonymized. And there you have it. Data analytics is a fast-paced, ever-changing industry. It's an industry that will always keep you on your toes. And that's why we hope this video was helpful to you and will set you up for success in 2023 and beyond. These are just some of the trends that I thought were useful. Let us know in the comments if you think we missed out any cool trends. I'm only human, I'm not a machine yet. Also, are you looking to kickstart your career in data analytics, but are not sure where to begin? Well, we've got you covered. Career Foundry has a free online data analytics short course that will allow you to dip your toes into this exciting field, and hey, you may even love it. The link to the short course is in the description below. As already mentioned, watching this video will help you get set up for success in the future analytics market, but if you need to see the exact steps you need to take, why don't you check out this video here? After many years in the field, I went over how I would start over and what I would start over with to get that great first work experience. So it should definitely be valuable if you're considering it. Go watch it here, and I'll see you next time.